Hello, hello, hello everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope that you're really excited for today's video because I'm really excited too. Today I thought that we were going to talk about my favorite indie games. Last video I made that was like this was about my favorite cozy games, and even though some of them are indie games and some of these games are cozy games, I would really like to share some of my favorites with you. Something that I really love about indie games is that you can truly feel the passion that's put into the specific game that you're playing. The games are very individual and they have their own things that makes the game special. And I thought it'd be really cool to share which are my favorite. This is just my top five. There are many, many good indie games out there. There are many good indie games to come, and there are also so many indie games that I haven't played at all. And if you did watch this year's Summer Game Fest 2022, you might have seen that there's a lot of good indie games coming up. I also kind of feel like my wallet's gonna be wrecked after watching that indie developer showcase, but I'm also really excited for all the amazing indie games that are coming up, and I cannot wait to test out some of them. But without further ado, I think it is time that we get into the first game. So the first game that I want to mention is Oxenfree. There is actually a new Oxenfree game coming out pretty soon, which I am so excited for. This game I actually played with a few friends when we had a game night, and it blew my mind how good it was. Like, I had watched the trailer, it looked good, but I feel like the more you got to know the characters and the small little secrets, it just got better and better, honestly. I really love this game. It definitely, that was the first thing that came to mind when I wanted to make my indie list, to be honest. It's really good. Oxenfree is without a doubt one of the best games I have ever played indie game-wise. It is a thriller story-driven game about a group of friends who goes for a sleepover on an old island. While they sit around the campfire, the night takes a turn for the scarier when the rift opens. You play the game by having conversations with all the characters, and you learn a lot about the main character Alex as well. It is you as a player that makes the choices that determines the story whilst you discover its dark history. This game is truly made with stunning colors, really mystic music, and it really adds to the spookiness of the game. You can play this game on PC, Mac, Xbox, PlayStation, and the Switch, and you can actually also play it on your phone. So there's loads of ways that you can play this game, and I do highly suggest that you try it out. It is a little spooky, but I wouldn't say it's so scary that people who are generally scared of something thrillery or scary would not be able to play it. I did get a little scared, to admit, but I could get through it, and I feel like most people could do it if I can do it. What Remains of Edith Finch is the second game that I would like to mention. It is also a game which I didn't have super high expectations about. I didn't really know a lot about the game until I tried it, and it was so good. It is not a very long game, but it is truly a game that goes into so many deep places of family history and how people's destinies ended up being, and I just really love that about this game. It is stunning. It really puts you in a position where you feel with the character you play as, Edith, and her family as well. It is very cool. I don't know how they came up with this idea, but I really, really love it. What Remains of Edith Finch is played in a first-person perspective as you go through the game as Edith, the last living family member, while she discovers all the secrets and the history of her family. All the stories of every single family member feel very, very different from each other's, and the feel is very much of its own. It is a truly stunning game, and even though the stories are incredibly sad, they're also at the same time incredibly beautifully portrayed. This game truly takes you on an emotional roller coaster. Couldn't recommend it enough, but make sure you bring a tissue box when you play this game, because it is also very, very sad. You can play this game on PC, Xbox, PlayStation, and the Nintendo Switch. You've got lots of platforms in order to try this out. The next game I have in store for you is definitely not a new game, but it's a game called Brothers: A Tale of Two Sons. It's truly a game that made a big impact on me. I played this game a really long time ago, honestly, and it was one of the first games that I ever properly played. I was always afraid to get into gaming. I felt like that wasn't something that I was supposed to do and therefore actually avoided gaming for a very long time. But there was a classmate in high school that recommended this game for me and I tested it out and I absolutely loved it. I feel like this is the game that opened not just my mind for gaming but also for the indie world of games, and that made me really, really happy. So it has a lot of meaning to me. Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. As you can hear from the name, it is about two brothers who are trying to save their father's life. You can play this game in co-op or as a single player. You head for their big adventure in search of the water of life and travel through puzzles, amazing boss fights, and stunning location. This game truly has it all. It's got the music, it's got the art, and an amazing story. This truly is a good game, and I highly recommend you try it as well. And if you do want to do so, it is available on PC, on Mac, PlayStation, Xbox, Nintendo, Switch, and also for your phone. So you have no excuse to not try this game out. Now, if you're into the indie scene, farming sims, or cozy games, this game will not be a shocker for you, but it has been my recent obsession. I don't know how I didn't get into this game earlier, but I needed to bring it up. Stardew is a game made by one single person, which truly makes everything about this game like 100 times better, to be completely honest. I didn't think I could fall in love with a game this much, but I truly have. I'm completely love-struck with it, and I cannot stop playing it right now. Stardew Valley is a pixel game where you make your own character and you take over your grandfather's old farm. You start your farming journey in a little town where you get to meet new people, learn new skills, and build up your farm. There are many parts of this game that I love, from the music, to the dialogues, and the cutscenes. The game truly, truly has it all, and you can play it in whatever phase you want to. I truly love how inclusive and special this game is, and I don't think that there is a single person who could not like this game. I feel like you couldn't dislike this, like it's just that good. And even though it's grown as Even though it's pretty known as far as indie games go, I do think that if you haven't tried this out and you're considering it, this is your time. Now is the time you do it. It's an inclusive game. You can play it in whatever way you want to. You can focus on whatever you want to. It doesn't matter. It can be a little overwhelming in the start of the game, but if you take it in your own phase, I'm sure that you're gonna love it as much as I do. This game, as well as the other games, is available on several platforms. It's on PC, Mac, PlayStation, Xbox, Switch, and yes, you guessed it, it's on your phone as well. So you really, really will be able to play this on so many different platforms, which I think is absolutely amazing. So coming up for our final game, I want to mention this gem. Don't Starve Together. Now, there is a game called Don't Starve, and there is a sort of expansion called Don't Starve Together. I haven't played just Don't Starve, to be completely honest. The only actual difference, as far as I understand, is that in this one, you play it as a co-op game. So you can play it with friends, and even though it's a little spooky, it's really cute as well, and I really, really love it. This was a game that I started playing during the pandemic. Whilst you couldn't really go out and do anything, and I wanted to be able to hang out with my friends, so we all got this game and played from our homes whilst chatting together, and it was really fun. I love it. It's quirky, it's a bit scary, it's a bit cute, and it's got a good story, so it's truly a game that I would recommend to anyone to try playing. Don't Starve or Don't Starve Together, if you want to play it in multiplayer, is a survival game where you pick among a handful of characters with their own stories and abilities, and you have to survive out in the wild. You have to find materials, craft, and build up your camp, and the art of the game is truly amazing. The different stories that unravel are also really cool. Just make sure that you don't starve. This game is really fun to play with friends. I'm sure it's really fun to play alone as well. I would say it's not an easy game, and I think that can be a good thing. It's truly a little puzzling, and you really need to figure out what to prioritize in order to not starve. And I really like that. The name of the game really suits it, and the aesthetics of it really, really pleases me. This game is also available on several platforms. Peace. PC, Mac, Xbox, PlayStation, and Switch. So make sure to test this out. Truly is a good one. That was my top 5 favorite indie games that I have played so far. I'm sure I'm gonna be playing loads and loads of more indie games, so maybe I'll make an updated list once I've tried a few more. But these are truly good. Some of them are newer, some of them are older, but they're all incredibly good. I highly, highly recommend that you try them out. If you do, please let me know what you thought of it. If you have a favorite indie game that you think I should try, please feel free to comment below, give me a suggestion, that would mean a lot. I always love getting suggestions for new games to test out, and I'm really excited to do so in the future. I do hope that you enjoy this video. If you don't know me from before, I also stream on Twitch. You can check the link below to my other social medias, and I'm so happy to have you here. It would mean a lot to me if you wanted to subscribe, like this video, and leave a comment. I'm really happy you watched the video, and thank you for making it this far. I hope you will have an amazing day, night, evening, whichever time it is for you, and hopefully I get to see you all very, very soon. Okay, bye!